This is the second experiment that we are doing with the help of our vernier calipers. The aim is to measure the internal diameter and the depth of the beaker or aerometer by using a vernier calipers and hence find its volume. So you will see that the apparatus needed for this experiment, it can be a beaker or a calorimeter, vernier calipers and a reading lens. This is a vernier calipers, you can see it here. These are the outside jaws, so this is where you keep the things to measure whose external diameter has to be calculated. Now these are the inside jaws. Now these inside jaws are actually used to measure the internal diameter of an object. Now these are the inside jaws of the vernier calipers. These inside jaws are used to measure the internal diameter of any hollow object. So here we use a small beaker. So we will try to find out the internal diameter. So for trying to find the internal diameter, you have to move this vernier slider, keep it here and move it and see that the inside jaws actually fits the diameter, inside diameter of the beaker or any hollow object whose measurement you have to take. This part is the main scale which will give you the main scale reading. So this is the main scale of the vernier calipers and this part is the tail of the vernier calipers. This portion that's called as the tail is used to measure the depth of an object. This portion is called as the tail of the vernier calipers and this tail is used to measure the depth of the object. So to measure the depth of the object, you have to place the tail into the vessel whose depth has to be measured. Care has to be taken that the tip of the tail has to hit the bottom of the beaker in this case and this edge should touch the rim of the vessel. So you can see that now here this reading over here will give you the depth of the object. Now we will find the internal diameter of this beaker by using the inside jaws of the vernier calipers. For this we have to place the inside jaws of the vernier calipers, move the vernier slider and move it in a gentle way such that the inside jaws secure the two diametrically opposite points of the beaker. Take this out and carefully measure the readings. Here we can notice that the zero marking of the main scale coincides with the first line of the vernier scale reading. So we can say that there is no zero error in this case. So zero error is nil. If the zero of the vernier scale is to the right side of the main scale, then it is positive zero error. And if the zero of the vernier scale is to the left side of the main scale, then it is negative zero error. This portion is called as the sliding vernier scale and you can see here the small divisions here. This represents the vernier scale divisions. Now let us try to find out the magnitude of one main scale division, that is MSD. Now if you check the number of divisions between 9 and 10, you can see that there are 10 divisions. So we can say that the first line here corresponds to 0.1 centimeter.
So here we can see in the theory that the least count is the least measurement that can be taken by an instrument. So magnitude of one main scale division in this vernier that we had used is 0.1 centimeter. So it is 0.1 centimeter and the number of divisions on the vernier scale which is represented by n was 10. Therefore, the least count of vernier calipers is 1 mean scale division divided by the number of divisions, that is n. So 1 MSD by n is equal to 0.1 divided by 10, so which will give you 0.01 centimeter. Now earlier we have seen there was no zero error in this vernier calipers, so we mentioned here the zero error of the vernier as nil.
Note the reading within the elliptical region. It can be seen that the zero marking of the vernier scale corresponds with the line of this main scale. So this will give you the main scale reading, and here the main scale reading is 4.6. At the same time, now if you look the line or the division of the vernier scale that corresponds with the main scale reading, here you can see it is the fourth division of the vernier scale. So we can say that the vernier scale division is 4 and the main scale reading is 4.6.
We had observed that the main scale reading was 4.6. The vernier scale reading was 4, and therefore the total reading, that is the main scale reading plus the vernier scale reading into the least count, so that will give us 4.6 plus 4 into 0.01 centimeter. So the final answer will be 4.64 centimeter. So this 4.64 centimeter will be the internal diameter of the beaker that we have used here. Similarly, we can have a set of 5 readings and find the mean diameter. Since our vernier calipers did not have any kind of zero error, therefore the corrected diameter will be same as the mean diameter.
Now we will try to find the depth of the vessel. So to find the depth of the vessel, we have to use the tail of the vernier calipers. Gently place the tail of the vernier calipers such that the tip of the tail of the vernier calipers hits the bottom, and this edge gently rests on the rim of the beaker. So we can see that it is this way here, and then the measurement has to be taken from this side, and we have to check for the main scale reading and the vernier scale reading here. So now let us check over here. Careful observations shows that the first division on the vernier scale coincides with the marking of 6.8 on the main scale reading. So we can say that the main scale reading here is 6.8 centimeter. At the same time, now if we observe for the line or the division on the vernier scale that corresponds with one of the line of the main scale, we can say that it can be the seventh division that coincides with the main scale. So this seventh one. So the vernier scale reading will be 7 and the main scale reading will be 6.8 centimeter.
So the main scale reading is 6.8 centimeter and the vernier scale reading was 7. Therefore the total reading is main scale reading plus vernier scale reading into least count, so that will be 6.8 8 plus 7 into 0.01. Which will be equal to 6.87 centimeter. So we can say that the depth or the height of this beaker is approximately 6.87 centimeter. Similarly, we have to take a total of 5 sets of reading, then find out the mean height or the mean depth. And since our vernier caliper that we have used here does not have any kind of zero error, so the corrected depth remains the same as that of the mean depth. Now to find out the volume of this beaker, we have to use the formula pi r square h. As we have seen that the volume of a cylinder is given by the formula pi r square h, substitute the values for pi, the radius and the height. So the pi is 3.14. In the previous calculation we had found that the diameter was 4.64. To get the radius divided by 2, so that will yield 2.32, and the height was 6.87. Substitute this value and multiply it, you will get the volume as 116 cm³.